you must be wondering why ICTB is so generous to the World Bank. But let me say why, and I think that this will be my initial, a very important point which will set the stage for this presentation. Many of you remember after the December 26, 2004 tsunami, one story which was in the media all over the world was about a British girl who was with her parents on a vacation in a resort in Thailand.
And she had studied. Excuse me for interrupting for a moment, a technical problem. Can somebody get that clock going, please? Okay.
So I was telling you about a story as to why it is important to talk about education and training in the context of disaster risk management. This British high school girl who had studied about tsunami in her geography class could see the sea waves receding pretty fast, and that was basically the sign of a tsunami coming. They were on a resort with her parents and there were 1,000 other families. She immediately alerted everyone that there is a tsunami coming to this island. So the 1,000 families basically took shelter on a higher elevation, whatever they had available there, and about 1,000 families were saved. Same thing happened actually in a village in Tamil Nadu in India, where during a program on disaster risk management education and training for the communities, for the local governments, one had gone through the whole exercise of identifying what are the hazards to which the community is prone to, and they had learned about tsunami. And this essentially helped the entire village to evacuate and go to higher places. And therefore, there was not a single death in that village, though villages actually beyond this, from the shoreline, there were 100% casualties. What I'm trying to say is that the importance of education and training in the context of disaster risk management is so much that essentially you're talking about saving lives. And therefore, this subject essentially is becoming more and more important. What I wanted to mention is that, first of all, the World Bank is looking at disaster risk management as a very important component of its sustainable development agenda. With tsunami, volcanoes, hurricanes, floods, drought all over the world, even as of today when we speak, we have these situations in different parts of the world, and several governments are engaged in either evacuation or providing relief to the people or going through a massive recovery and reconstruction program, be it Pakistan floods or Haiti earthquake. The bank has essentially embarked on a major initiative together with the United Nations and several donor governments to start working more and more on disaster prevention and disaster preparedness in these countries. What I wanted to mention quickly is that the problem of our vulnerability to natural hazards in these countries will continue to become more and more complex. What you have on this slide essentially is the disaster hotspots in the world in terms of earthquake, landslides, volcanoes, tsunamis, drought, etc. But if you, on this, if you bring the other layers of vulnerabilities of the different countries in the world, you'll find you have several countries prone to extreme stress of hunger. You have the likely impact of the climate change in terms of the crop decline in several parts of the world, which will essentially affect your food security situation. Further, you have the stress of the water scarcity in different countries, combined with the whole question of migration and mobility because of many factors, as we have noticed already in several parts of the world. Over and above this, you have the likely increase in the storm surges, which might inundate more areas, and particularly the coastal states and the cities and the countries are at much higher risk in many parts of the world. Over and above this, you had recent history of conflicts in many parts of the world. There may be more conflicts in future because of the increasing stress in terms of natural resources, in terms of increasing mobility, and the changing, fast-changing demographic balance. What essentially means is that as different countries go through a number of stress factors, both coming from the natural hazards, but also other social and environmental factors, it is important that we start working with the governments to essentially have a very solid education and training program to train the civil servants, to train the communities, and to make this essentially as a part of national human resource development agenda, because you need a very large number of people in the countries to deal with the natural disasters. Now, how are we looking at it? First of all, we think that most of the presentations made today, I think we have an opportunity to include the subject of disaster risk management in all the learning programs which are mentioned today. Whether it's an elementary school or a high school or a tertiary education program or a technical education program, it is important to bring the subject of disaster risk management in all these programs. Many countries have successfully done it, where they have integrated the disaster risk reduction in the elementary schools from Indonesia to Bangladesh to India. Many countries have started looking at the disaster risk reduction in the higher education programs as well. You have many universities today in Africa, in Asia, in the Caribbean and Central America, where they offer master's program in disaster risk management. So there is already a growing awareness of the importance of bringing the new generation of disaster risk management professionals, either in the civil service or in the civil society, to be more aware and to be equipped to deal with the situations. What we are doing very briefly, I would like to mention here, and I think we have opportunity here for us as World Bank to work with many of the networks, learning networks, university networks in different parts of the world that I have come to know today, and we would like to work with you. The focus essentially is that there is a huge demand of the professionals in these countries, in the local governments or the federal governments, who really understand what these disaster risks are, how they can be managed, how can you spread your disaster risk, how can you basically work on various kind of financial protection measures. So we would like to help countries professionalize education in disaster risk management through our programs in the countries in partnership with various universities and governments. What I wanted to mention is the four principles in terms of how we work on the program. One is essentially we do not directly engage in providing education and training. We are increasingly trying to work with our partners and provide them the tools and the expertise to be able to implement large-scale disaster risk management programs. Second is that based on the World Bank's own expertise over the last 40 years, initially primarily on disaster reconstruction, but increasingly more and more disaster prevention operations in different parts of the world, based on which we are developing state-of-the-art curriculum. But then when we start a program in the region, we do it together with our partner to see what curriculum will be most relevant for that particular region or the country where we begin working on this. The third essentially is that any model that we work on must be scalable and sustainable. So the programs that we essentially do in the countries are not directly implemented by us. It is implemented by the partners, and they also charge a certain amount of money which the students have to pay to learn, either through the online programs or through the face-to-face or the blended programs. So it also is a cost recovery model in this, which allows the institutions to run the program. We have ongoing programs in several regions of the world. I just wanted to mention a few, for example, where we have made quite a bit of progress through the ASEAN arrangements in Southeast Asia, through SAARC in South Asia, with ISPAC, which is a Nairobi-based organization under the IGAD. We have a program. I see that I have just 1 minute left. What I wanted to also mention is that we are increasingly moving towards a more structured learning program, and also encouraging professional certification across the world so that we have a more organized way of looking at the DRM education and learning. This is not where we have implemented. This is the direction in which we are moving, and I think we would like to work with you on this. These are some examples of the program, how we do. We have a program with the Arab Academy launched recently, which is essentially targeting the Arab youth and see how we can train more Arab professionals in disaster risk management. Similarly, we just concluded a large program with the ASEAN, and this is being continued in Southeast Asia. And finally, this is a program on South Asia. Thank you.